game number two. Second game of the doubleheader, Chargers and the Broncos. Denver 3-43 the total. Surprised that total is sitting at 43. Last 10 years, the Broncos 7-1 straight up and 6-2 ATS, the first game of the season, last 8 years. Altitude should help. Maybe the teams aren't conditioned as well, especially when there's less hitting in camp. How much will they miss Ward, who was surprisingly cut last weekend? And remember, they were nasty when they won the Super Bowl, but pretty good defense last year, but they could not stop the run.
Yeah, and of course, you talk about 43, and that total stands out. As we speak, the markets are moving to 42 and a half, posted 43. Obviously, that was what it was when we started to record, but we are seeing under money in this ballgame, and we have seen Denver enjoy a very strong home field edge in that first meeting of the season. Think about preseason. Nobody plays more than a half in general. You know, maybe some of the guys get on the field for the third quarter in week three, but guys aren't max conditioned in week one. They're just not. They haven't played enough game ways. So the fact that you're playing in altitude, it has mattered for Denver over the years. They've been pretty good in these first openers at home, their opening day game at home. But you talk about TJ Ward. I mean, that was a shocking cut to me. And we're also talking about a team that, again, you're losing one of the key playmakers from their secondary, from a defense that was, oh, by the way, you know, truly elite. Look at the numbers. Look at the graphic. Last year, Denver's QB rating allowed under 70. The number two team over 75. The NFL average close to 88. So Denver effectively lapped the field. Ward was one of the biggest playmakers on that defense. And now they also have depth concerns on the defensive line. Multiple injuries for Denver in terms of their pass rush tonight. So a squad that led the NFL in pass defense by wide margins in back-to-back seasons, well, I mean, now they're going to be relying on Justin Simmons, a guy who played mostly on special teams last year, to take Ward's place. And, of course, we're not talking about necessarily an elite offense. Trevor Siemian, you know, he's been serviceable. I don't know that he brings a whole lot of upside. It is worth noting, though, Mike McCoy is drawing up the plays for Denver, and I don't know if there's a whole lot of people in the world that have a more intimate knowledge of San Diego's defensive weaknesses, or certainly their personnel, than Mike McCoy, the Chargers' former head coach. He should know those Chargers defenders well.
Also, McCoy probably knows how to slow down that offense and how you contain Rivers as well. They underachieved under McCoy. Injuries were a big part, though. They lost more players, games to injury than any other team in McCoy's four seasons. They were in the bottom five in the league in each season as well. No Perriman. And we'll see if Rivers can take advantage of this Denver defense without Ward. Now, something to watch, too. Rivers didn't move to L.A. He's commuting. He's driving 70 miles to the facility for practice. He decided to commute with a tricked-up ride. As you see the picture here, he hopes that watching game films during the commute will help. Quote, there will be some days we're hoping to get in a little traffic because we have more work to do. That is fascinating to watch in that one. Hey, guys, for the full video, go to sbrpicks.com.
Hey guys, thanks for tuning in to our channel. Now we've put a lot of work into producing all these free videos, so please help us out and keep all our content free for you forever by simply liking, sharing, commenting, and subscribing. Now not to mention, a visit to our industry-leading website will warm the hearts of all our SBR employees, especially myself. Now the links are over there to the left, so do check those out. Thanks for watching.